Meantime, a state representative who is also a former Marine and federal agent is eyeing his own run for that same Senate seat, saying Pierre and Washington, D.C. are afflicted with the same corrupt political disease.
State Representative Stace Nelson of Fulton says that he thinks South Dakotans should know that in many ways, Pierre and Washington, D.C. are suffering what he says are the same Chicago-style politics that he also believes are plaguing the Obama administration. And while Nelson says he'd love to stay home and enjoy his rural life in his native state, he also says it might be time to try and make a difference in Washington, D.C.
You may never have heard the name Stace Nelson, but at the state capitol in Pierre, his name brings strong reaction as a conservative lawmaker unwilling to go along with the status quo.
I didn't run and I don't serve in the legislature at the whim or the behest of the governor or David Lust or Brian Gosch or any of those folks. I serve for the South Dakotans and I vote the way I told them I would based off my principles.
Standing all of 6'5" and with the stout build of a former Marine, Stace Nelson casts a broad shadow on South Dakota politics. A former federal agent who's garnered a quick reputation as a man with passionate beliefs and plain-spoken eloquence. Someone who would much rather do what he believes to be right than win political points.
When you stand on your principles, it provides a stark contrast to those people that try to fool South Dakotans into thinking they're conservatives to get elected.
But that no-nonsense approach has gained Nelson his share of enemies on the political left, and even inside the Republican Party, where Nelson says he's less concerned with following party leadership than in keeping promises to voters.
It's a rude awakening. You find out that not every Republican that carries that R believes or actually votes to limit government and cut spending and also protect South Dakotans from tax raises.
All clear signs, Nelson believes, that the mainstream GOP has lost its conservative roots in South Dakota, something he says is equally emblematic in the candidacy of Mike Rounds, whom Nelson says has much in common with the policies of Barack Obama, all while talking a conservative South Dakota message.
Via his administration and the Dugard administration, there has been bills passed that help implement Obamacare in the state of South Dakota. But at the same time, you've got Mike Rounds telling folks that he's a conservative, he's going to go to the D.C. and fight spending and fight the expansion of government and fight Obamacare. But he did the actual opposite when he was a governor here in the state of South Dakota.
Motivation, Nelson says, that might prompt him to leave behind the small-town comforts of rural South Dakota life and try to be of service in Washington, D.C.
Last thing South Dakotans or Americans need is more government on their back. And we've had a long line of professional, pragmatic politicians going to D.C., Shad, and going along to get along, growing more government, growing more national debt, to the point that it is actually now threatening the very existence of our country.
And Stace Nelson believes that Kristi Noem's own decision not to run for U.S. Senate was influenced at least in part by that same political machinery that he referenced there in South Dakota. He says in the interest of keeping the House seat closed and making it more difficult for grassroots GOP candidates to pick a cheaper race, that being the House race, and win that rather than having to run for Senate, where estimates are it could cost $10 million to get elected this time around.